According to a new study published in the journal Nature, economists and polar scientists from the University of Cambridge and Erasmus University Rotterdam found that unlocking frozen reserves of methane in the Arctic would speed global warming and cause destructive and costly climatic changes across the planet. In fact, listen to this number, man. This absolutely blew my mind earlier. Quote, the release of methane from thawing permafrost beneath the East Siberian Sea off northern Russia alone comes with an average global price tag of $60 trillion in the absence of mitigating action. That number is so high, it's comparable to the size of the world economy. In 2012, the world economy, $70 trillion. And that's not even the total cost of climate change and how it would affect the Arctic. They're only talking about the specific East Siberian Sea just off northern Russia. $60 trillion. Many experts now say if recent trends continue and Arctic sea ice continues its death spiral, we will see a, quote, near ice-free Arctic summer within a decade. Now, when I grew up, I'm not old either, I'm 25 years old. When I grew up, the thought of the Arctic, everybody's like, oh yeah, ice all over the place and snow. That's it. That's all that comes to mind. Boom, that's it. Well, now we're learning, no. Within the decade, it might be ice-free in the summer. Do you realize how fast this is barreling down on us, how fast climate change is happening? Well, experts also say if we continue at this rate, we may usher in permanent change towards extreme prolonged weather events such as drought, flooding, cold spells, and heat waves. We're in for a lot of trouble, man. You know, the problem is that we don't have any foresight. So it's only nerds and dorks and policy wonks that are reading these articles on a daily basis, and they're not covering it on the mainstream media, certainly not to the degree that they're supposed to be, right? So everybody just expects, oh, we're going to wake up tomorrow, it's going to be the same as today. That's just the way things are, right? Until one day you wake up and you go, oh fuck, southern Florida is disappearing. Oh fuck, Louisiana is completely gone. Oh fuck, there's no more fresh water in the Midwest. There's so many pieces to climate change that will screw us up in so many ways, whether it be the food chain getting messed up and as a result, the prices for food in the supermarket shooting up to ridiculous numbers. The Midwest and the West are going to run out of water one day. Do you understand what that means? They get their water now from snow caps on mountaintops, but those snow caps aren't going to be there because global warming's taking them away. So where are they going to get their fresh water from? And then people say, oh, you just get it from the underground reservoirs. You'll be all right. Yeah, but the underground reservoirs, they're now contaminated because the fracking industry is exempt from the Clean Water Act, so there's benzene and chemicals and carcinogens in the water, so you can't get it from anywhere. Where are you going to get it from? Look, it's a laundry list of issues. Did you know Alaska in recent times is experiencing wildfires? Alaska is experiencing wildfires. What are we doing, man? What are we doing? If you can't look at this number and realize, okay, these are scientists, these are researchers, these are experts in the field. They're saying, hello, wakey wakey, $60 trillion, and that's not even the total cost. 60 trillion. The war in Iraq by the year 2053 is 7 trillion. This makes that look like peanuts. Like your allowance money or something. Like you go out and buy a Coca-Cola with that money. It's so tiny amount, it's $60 trillion. But everybody sits around. No, it's time for the government to take immediate action. And of course, the problem is that ExxonMobil and the fossil fuel industry, they pay the politicians, so the politicians don't want to do anything that might cut into their profits. But if you don't cut into their profits, then we have nothing but perpetual fossil fuel use, and we don't move towards green technology, and we're perpetuating the problem of global warming and making it worse. It's time to do something before the polar bears catch on fire.